I'll just sit here. Maybe later I'll get some of the other stories back there. But I brought this one so I'd have something ready to read, as it were. This one, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. You guys know that story?
Yeah.
Okay. You can almost sing it. You know that?
I watched it.
You did? Well, maybe I'll turn sideways for this. Now, this is a pop-up book. You guys know what that does, right?
Yes, it pops up the picture.
Exactly. If we haven't read them too many times. Okay, here we go. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. And it was an exciting day in Christmas Town. All the young deer were going to compete in their very first reindeer games. The ones who were the best would join Santa's team when they grew up. When it was time for the flying game, Rudolph soared into the air. Everyone cheered until a fake black nose that he always wore popped off. Underneath, his real nose glowed bright red. The other reindeer stared at Rudolph and laughed at him for being different. Rudolph sadly wandered off, but soon he made a new friend in Hermie the Elf. The other elves had made fun of Hermie because he didn't want to make toys. Instead, he longed to be a dentist. So Hermie and Rudolph struck out to look for a place where they could fit in. Soon they joined up with a prospector named Yukon Cornelius. It wasn't long before the abominable snow monster saw Rudolph's glowy nose and chased after them. Yukon Cornelius used his axe to make an iceberg and they floated away to safety. Everybody see this? Okay. The friends landed on the island of Misfit Toys. It was filled with toys that no one wanted because they were different too. The Misfits included a train, with square wheels, an elephant with spots, and a boat that couldn't float. A winged lion named King Moonracer ruled the island. He wanted Rudolph to tell Santa about the lonely toys. I'm sure he could find little girls and boys who would be happy with them. King Moonracer, said Rudolph, promised that he would deliver the king's message. You see that over there? Okay. That night, Rudolph set off by himself. He didn't want his shining red nose to put his friends in danger again. After many months, he reached Christmas Town, but his mother and father were nowhere to be found. They, along with his friend Clarice, had gone out looking for him. On a hunch, Rudolph went to the cave of the abominable snow monster, the beast holding his parents and Clarice captive inside. Yukon Cornelius and Hermes showed up just in time and turned the snow monster from terrifying to toothless. The reindeer and Irma headed home in a huge blizzard. It was Christmas Eve when they finally arrived at Santa's workshop. Everyone was relieved to see the weary travelers. They were sorry that they had treated Rudolph and Hermie so badly. Santa was worried that the storm would make it too dangerous to fly that night. Then he had an idea. Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? He asked. It will be an honor, sir, Rudolph answered proudly. Don't you like these pop-up books?
Yeah.
This one's really big. The elves loaded the giant sack of presents onto Santa's sleigh and harnessed up their reindeer team. Up, up, and away, Santa cried. After a quick stop at the island of Misfit Toys, he carefully delivered each plaything to the child who would love it just the way it was. It was a very merry Christmas all over the world, thanks to Rudolph and his one-of-a-kind, perfectly wonderful nose. And that's that story. Did you guys like that?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I'll let you look around with your parents and stuff now, and I might just find some other books to read later of today, okay? Okay.